Shall I give the order, sir?
No. I have a better idea.
People of Duloc, I give you our champion!
What?
Congratulations, Ogre. You've won the honor of embarking on a great and noble quest.
Quest? I'm already on a quest. A quest to get my swamp back.
Your swamp?
Yeah, my swamp, where you dumped those fairy tale creatures.
Indeed. All right, Ogre, I'll make you a deal. Go on this quest for me, and I'll give you your swamp back.
Exactly the way it was.
Down to the last slime-covered toadstool.
And the squatters?
As good as gone.
What kind of quest?
Okay, let me get this straight. You're gonna go fight a dragon and rescue a princess just so Farquaad to give you back a swamp, which you only don't have because he filled it full of freaks in the first place. Is that about right?
You know what? Maybe there's a good reason donkeys shouldn't talk.
I don't get it, Shrek. Why don't you just pull some of that ogre stuff on him, you know, throttle him, lay siege to his fortress, grind his bones to make your bread, you know, the whole ogre trip.
Oh, I know what. Maybe I could have decapitated an entire village and put their heads on a pike, got a knife, cut open their spleen and drink their fluids. Does that sound good to you?
No, not really, no.
For your information, there's a lot more to ogres than people think.
Example?
Example? Okay, ogres are like onions.
They stink?
Yes. No.
Oh, they make you cry?
No.
Oh, you leave them out in the sun, they get all brown, start sprouting little white hairs.
No. Layers. Onions have layers. Ogres have layers. Onions have layers. You get it. We both have layers.
Oh, you both have layers. Oh. You know, not everybody likes onions.
Cake! Everybody loves cakes. Cakes have layers.
I don't care what everyone likes. Ogres are not like cakes.
You know what else everybody likes? Parfaits. Have you ever met a person you say, hey, let's get some parfaits? They say, hell no, I don't like no parfaits. Parfaits are delicious.
No! You dense, irritating, miniature beast of burden. Ogres are like onions. End of story. Bye-bye. See you later.
Oh, you almost had it.
I'm never gonna defeat Zurge.
Sure you will, Rex. In fact, you're a better Buzz than I am.
But look at my little arms. I can't press the fire button and jump at the same time.
Where is it? Where is it?
Woody?
Huh?
Oh, hang on, cowboy. Woody, are you all right?
No. Yeah, I'm fine, Buzz. Okay, here's your list of things to do while I'm gone. Batteries need to be changed. Toys at the bottom of the chest need to be rotated. Oh, and make sure everyone attends Mr. Spell Seminar on what to do if you or part of you is swallowed. Okay? Okay, good, okay.
Woody, you haven't found your hat yet, have you?
No! And Annie's leaving for cowboy camp any minute, and I can't find it anywhere!
Don't worry, Woody. In just a few hours, you'll be sitting around a campfire with Andy making delicious hot schmoes.
They're called s'mores, Buzz.
Right, of course. Has anyone found what he's at yet?
Keep looking, man! Dig deeper! Negatory! Still searching!
The lawn gnome next door says it's not in the yard, but he'll keep looking.
It's not in Molly's room. We've looked everywhere.
I found it!
You found my hat?
Your hat? No, the missus lost her earring. Oh, my little sweet potato!
Oh, you found it! Oh, it's so nice to have a big, strong around the house.
Oh, great. That's just great. This will be the first year I miss cowboy camp, all because of my stupid hat.
Woody, look under your boot.
Don't be silly. My hat is not under my boot.
Would you just look?
You see? No hat. Just the word Andy.
Uh-huh. And the boy who wrote that would take you to camp with or without your hat.
I'm sorry, Bo. It's just that I've been looking forward to this all year. It's my one time with just me and Andy.
You're cute when you care.
Oh, not in front of Buzz.
Let him look.
Miss Pete! Miss Pete!
Hey, kids, this is Al from Al's Toy Barn, and I'm sitting on the deal here. Al, I think I'm feeling a deal hatching right now. Whoa. Let's see what we got. We got boats for a buck, beanies for a buck.
Turn it off! Someone's gonna hear!
Which one is off?
That's Chief Chief Chief. Hurry up!
Right out loud, it's this one. I despise that chicken.
Fellas. Okay. I got some good news, and I got some bad news.
What news?
Good news is I found your hat, Woody.
My hat? Oh, Slick, thank you. Where'd you find it?
Well, that's the bad news.
Woo, it's Buster!
K-9 alert! Man your battle station! Then boom, boom, boom!
Woody, hide, quick!
Okay, you found me, Buster, all right. Hey, how did he do, Ham?
Looks like a new record.
Okay, boy, sit. Reach for the sky. Gotcha! Oh, great job, boy. Who's gonna miss me while I'm gone, huh? Who's gonna miss me? Okay, have a good weekend, everybody. I'll see you Sunday night.
It's in my room.
Suivez-moi. Follow me. State your name.
Nemo?
Brother Bloat, proceed.
Nemo, newcomer of orange and white, you have been called forth to the summit of Mount Wanahakalugi to join with us in the fraternal bonds of tankhood.
Huh?
We want you in our club, kid.
Really?
If you are able to swim through the Ring of Fire! Turn on the Ring of Fire. The Ring of Fire! Oh. You said you could do it. The Ring of Fire!
From this moment on, you will now be known as Sharkbait.
Sharkbait! Ooh-ha-ha!
Welcome, Brother Sharkbait.
Sharkbait! Ooh-ha-ha!
Enough with the Sharkbait.
Sharkbait! Ooh-bop-ba-doo.
Okay, Sharkbait's one of us now. Agreed?
Agreed!
And we can't send him off to his death. Darla's coming in 5 days. So, what are we gonna do? I'll tell you what we're gonna do. We're gonna get him out of here. We're gonna help him escape.
Escape? Really?
We're all gonna escape.
Kill, please. Not another one of your escape plans.
Sorry, but they never work.
Yeah, why should this be any different?
Because we've got him.
Me?
You see that filter?
Yeah?
You're the only one who can get in and out of that thing. What we need you to do is take a pebble inside there and jam the gears. You do that, and this tank's gonna get filthier and filthier by the minute. Pretty soon, the dentist will have to clean the tank himself. And when he does, he'll take us out of the tank, put us in individual baggies, then we'll roll ourselves down the counter, out of the window, off the awning, into the bushes, across the street, and into the harbor. It's foolproof. Who's with me?
I.
I think you're nuts. No offense, kid, but you're not the best swimmer.
He's fine. He can do this. So, Sharkbait, what do you think?
Let's do it.
Busy Bee.
You're never gonna believe it. Oh, hey, I like your cone. Listen, I heard Chuck tell Liam that we're going on a trip.
Really? We're going in the car?
We're going in the car!
Oh, car! Man, you know life is funny. One minute you're getting fitted for a cone, and the next you get to go in a car!
Oh, I feel like that's very specific to you, but totally. Yeah.
Oh, this is incredible! I'll be right back. Chloe, I'm going on a trip tonight. Oh. I was wondering if you... Will you watch my Busy Bee while I'm gone?
Oh, hey, Max. Were you saying something?
Yeah. I was wondering if you...
Oh, God! Okay, never mind.
What's that stupid thing on your head?
Gidget! Gidget, are you home? Gidget?
Oh, hi, Max. Do you want to join me?
Oh, you know what? I really wish I could, but get this. I'm going on a trip.
Wow, really?
Yeah, it's a big deal. I was wondering, could you watch my Busy Bee while I'm gone?
He is so cute!
I know, it's my favorite toy in the whole world! And that little face! Come on, his little face! Oh, and, ready?
Oh, wow, I love him! Oh, I just love him immediately! It's like we're his parents. It's like you're the dad and I'm the mom and we're in a relationship and this is our baby.
Well...
It's exactly like that. Exactly!
It's that... Okay, yes. Yes, that's exactly what it is. So you'll watch Busy Bee while I'm gone?
Max, you go. Have a great time, and I want you to know, I haven't got this.
Thanks, Gidget. See you later.
I will defend Busy Bee with my life.
Thank God I lost my sense of taste years ago.
Aren't you going to pitch up your tent?
I did. I guess I'm still a little rusty at this. I haven't gone camping since the last time my grandpa took me.
I never got to meet your grandfather. What was he like?
Where do you start? He was like a father to me, really. My parents died when I was a little kid, and he took me in.
What?
I was just thinking. One time when I was eight, we were hiking along this stream. And I saw something shining in the water. It was a genuine arrowhead. Well, you'd think I'd found a lost civilization the way Grandpa carried on about it. It wasn't until I was older that I realized that the arrowhead was just some compressed shale mixed with zinc pyrite that had fractured into an isolated triangulate.
That is so cute.
Say, Audrey, no offense, but how did a teenager become the chief mechanic of a multimillion-dollar expedition?
Well, I took this job when my dad retired. But the funny thing was, he always wanted sons, right? One to run his machine shop, and the other to be middleweight boxing champion. But he got my sister and me instead.
So, what happened to your sister?
She's 24 and 0 with a shot at the title. next month. Anyway, I'm saving up so my puppy and I can open another shop.
Forget your jammies, Mrs. Packard?
I sleep in the nude.
You're gonna want a pair of these. She sleepwalks.
Well, as far as me goes, I just like to blow things up. Come on, Benny. Tell the kid the truth. My family owned a flower shop. We would sell roses, carnations, baby's breath, you name it. One day, I'm making about 3 dozen corsages for this pram, you know, the one they put on their wrist. And everybody, they come, where is it, when is it, does it match my dress? It's a nightmare. Anyway, I guess there was this leak next door of gas or what. Boom! No more Chinese laundry. Blew me right through the front window. It was like a sign from a god. I found myself that boom.
What's Mole's story?
Trust me on this one. You don't want to know. Audrey, don't tell him. You shouldn't have told me, but you did. And now I'm telling you, you don't want to know.
My protection, great ancestor. You just say the word and I'm there.
Mushu.
And let me say something. Anybody who's foolish enough to threaten our family, vengeance will be mine.
Mushu. These are the family guardians. They
protect the family.
And you, O demoted one.
I ring the gong.
That's right. Now, wake up the ancestors.
One family reunion coming right up. Okay, people, look alive. Let's go. Come on, get up. Let's move it. Rise and shine. You're all way past the beauty sleep thing. Trust me.
I knew it. I knew it. That Mulan was a troublemaker from the start.
Don't look at me. She gets it from your side of the family.
She's just trying to help her father.
But if she's discovered, Bajou will be forever shamed. Dishonor will come to the family. Traditional values will disintegrate.
Not to mention they'll lose the farm.
My children never caused such trouble. They all became acupuncturists.
Well, we can't all be acupuncturists.
No. Your great-granddaughter had to be a cross-dresser!
Let a guardian bring her back.
Yes, awaken the most cunning!
No, the swiftest.
No, send the wisest.
Silence! We must send the most powerful of all.
Okay, I get the drift. I'll go.
Well, y'all don't think I can do it.
Watch this here! Jump back, I'm pretty hot, huh? Well, maybe I have to send you, nobody proved no point.
You had your chance to protect the Pa family.
Your misguidance led Fa Thing to disaster.
Yeah, thanks a lot.
And your point is?
The point is, we will be sending a real dragon to retrieve Mulan.
What? I'm a real dragon!
You are not worthy of this spot. Now, awaken the great stone dragon.
So you get back to me on the job thing?